Hi there, Toy here, and today I'm shooting the Before I Was a Writer tag. So I saw this tag on Go Indie Now about a week ago. So yeah, I'm a little late. You know, I can't just, you know, push out these videos left and right because I have so much stuff going on. But I liked it and thought I'd give it a go. So I'm going to go ahead and go through my answers to all the questions, but I've also listed questions and answers in the links below. So yeah, be sure to check out Go Indie Now, and let's get right into it. Question number one is, the first book I read to its end. When I was thinking about answering this question, I had to consider the fact that I read a lot of books. But I feel like when you're a kid, a lot of books get read to you, or, you know, someone reads with you for part of it while you read the rest. And so I'm sure there's a lot of books I read from beginning to end, but I feel like maybe there was always a little effort from someone else involved. I feel like the first, what I consider chapter, it is a chapter book, but what I consider like the first real book that I read from cover to cover that was a chapter book was Jesus and Ramona, the first book in the Ramona series by Beverly Cleary. And I really feel like that's significant because I had read, you know, Charlotte's Web, Pippi Longstocking, different books like that, you know, all around that time and before that time, but I always feel like maybe there was someone else reading it with me. But I distinctly remember, you know, getting that Ramona book and reading it from cover to cover by myself and then being able to like say, okay, I want the next one. So yeah. Question number two, the first book I reread. I think this is going to be Fahrenheit 451 by Ray Bradbury. The first time I read it, it was assigned to me in school, and I don't know that I really read it. I was always pretty good at, I'm not a speed reader, but I was able to kind of get through the pages fairly quickly to make sure I understood everything that was happening in the story so that I could talk about it in class. And so I feel like I missed a lot. So later on, you know, after that class was over, at some point I decided to read the story Fahrenheit 451, especially after seeing the movie, which, I don't know. I guess for the time they did a pretty good job, but so yeah, I reread that book and I appreciated it much more afterwards. Next question. The first series I invested my life in. Now this question, I decided to take it and run with it because I'm gonna break it down. Pretty much all of the questions pertain to reading and writing, because you know it's Before I Was a Writer tag. But I'm gonna go into TV, movies, and books on this one. And I'm gonna start with TV. And this may sound a little odd, but I'm gonna explain it. The first TV series that I feel like I really invested my life in was Sliders, which ran from 1995 to 2000, but I actually stopped watching it in 1998. So let me explain. Obviously, there's all kinds of wonderful television that came on before that, and I totally watched it. But again, this kind of goes back to the first book that I read by myself. I feel like all the TV that I watched before that, I had someone else watching it with me. You know, I would watch it with my dad or my mom or a friend or something like that. When Sliders first came out, none of the people that I was associated were really into it, but I was. That first two seasons of Sliders, I just felt like, oh, this is the show for me. It really got me into interdimensional travel in a way that I hadn't really considered before. I remember I used to watch the Quantum Leap show with my dad, and you know, he would travel through time and, you know, stuff like that. And so I was already, you know, into the idea, but for some reason Sliders just hit it for me. Now after a couple of seasons, it just fell off and I didn't keep up with it. As far as movies go, again, so many movies in a series that, you know, I've watched with friends and families like that. And even this one kind of, but I really feel like this particular series, I was gonna watch it even if other people didn't want to watch it with me. Of course, most people did. I found out, years later that my mom had never seen it, which to me just solidifies the fact that I was into this and not because of anyone else's influence. And that was the Back to the Future series. And to this day, it's still one of my favorite movie series. I mean, obviously, Star Wars and all that stuff, I love those series, but I feel like, again, those were things that I participated in with other people. To me, I feel like this was the first movie series that I was like dedicated to, that no one else was really like influencing me with that. As far as books go, I would say it would be The Wizard of Oz and pretty much anything associated with The Wizard of Oz. More specifically, I read the first two books from The Wizard of Oz series when I was a kid, actually more like of a preteen because I didn't know about it when I was a kid until after seeing the movie. But I didn't realize how many books were in that series, and I kind of got discouraged and then never finished it. And I'm actually working on finishing that series now. But then as an adult, I discovered the Wicked series, which is, what the musical Wicked is based off of. It's the life and times of the Wicked Witch, but of course it goes on further into that, and that's written by Gregory Maguire. And so both of those series I was just kind of like dedicated to, even though other people around me at the time weren't really into it. I mean, I know so many people who are like, oh yeah, Wicked the musical, but I couldn't tell you anything about the actual series itself because most of the people that I kind of spend time with haven't read it, which I don't know. So yeah, those are the series that I feel like in, and then there are others, obviously, but those are the first series that I feel like I invested my life in, and I don't feel like it was based on an influence from anyone else. Number four says the first book I bought on with my own money. The first book I bought with my own money, it's crazy. I distinctly remember it, but I couldn't tell you the title of it. It was a children's book of poetry, and it had like nursery rhymes and stuff like that in it too. But I mean, it literally had like poems and things in it. It had some illustrations, and someone had given me a copy. I don't know how, maybe when I was a baby. I don't know. I just remember always having it, and I wore it out. And I remember being at like a Scholastic book fair, like school, and they had like the latest edition of it, and I was just blown away because I had never seen it before. I mean, as kids, you don't really pay attention to a lot of things around you. It was probably there all along. I do also remember spending my own money on a copy of the Walt Disney's Peter Pan book, which I bought after seeing the movie Peter Pan, the Disney cartoon version. But I was already into everything Peter Pan by that point anyway. So those are the first books that I remember spending my own money on. And you're like, you're a kid, where'd you get the money from? I did chores, I had a budget. I had a checkbook, people, by the time I was 12, and I knew how to balance it. So it was my money. All right, so number five, the first movie I saw because I read the book. Now this one may sound a little bit shocking, but there were so many movies that I saw in my lifetime growing up that were based off books, but that's not necessarily why I saw them. Or I didn't know that it was based on a book or something like that, but the first time I made a conscious effort to say, I'm going to watch that movie because I've already read the book, was Hunger Games. Yeah, I know. And it took me that long to put it all together and say, okay, I've read this whole book series. They're coming out with the movie. Let's check it out. Let's see. Question number six, the first book I read because I saw the movie. And this goes back to a question I've already answered. I saw the movie, The Wizard of Oz, the 1939 film starring Judy Garland, when I was a kid on TV, loved it, and then I read the book. So I was introduced to the movie first and then fell in love with the books and everything like that. So question number seven is the first review I ever wrote for a book or a movie. So I'm gonna go ahead and say that I'm gonna consider this to be more of a consumer type deal. I have written countless books reports because in school. I think all of those are technically reviews, but I'm not counting those because it was for school. I not that someone was making me do it, but I've also written several critical analysis again because of school. So I'm not counting any of that stuff, which is why a lot of times if you, well, not a lot of times, if you follow me on Goodreads, you'll see that I have quite a few books that I've rated but never reviewed because these were all books that I had, read before I started getting into the whole book review thing. So I didn't want to go back and rehash stuff. I just left my ratings and moved on. So I would say the first book that I officially, reviewed as, just a regular reader wanting to enjoy something would be Brave New World, by Aldous Huxley. And some people don't like the review that I left out. I don't care. It's my review. Number eight, a classic I read for school but ended up really loving. I kind of have two answers for this, but really it's just one. Like I said earlier, that I reread Fahrenheit because I read it in school and I really enjoyed it. But the real story that I am so glad that was introduced to me in school because it's left an impression on me, and I'll explain why in just a moment. Is the short story Rappaccini's Daughter, written by Nathaniel Hawthorne. And this one I did write a critical analysis on when I was in college. I did a comparison to that story and the story in Genesis about the Garden of Eden. And needless to say, there are so many parallels in the writing that I do that comes from Rappaccini's Daughter. I named the main character in my first novel Giovanni because of Rappaccini's Daughter. So I don't know that I ever would have come across that short story in my life had it not been because I got it from school, So question nine, the first job I thought I would have as a kid before a writer. This one is quite easy because up until probably my sophomore year in high school, pretty much thought I was going to be a doctor. I mean, I even feel like at this point I could go back to school and become a doctor. I just really don't like school. But I had realized, in high school that my people skills don't lean towards that direction. I don't have a problem with the blood and the guts and the sickness and stuff like that. It's just the idea of having to address people's illnesses and have that level of compassion. Not that I don't have it. I mean, I don't know if you know what I do for a living, but I have the compassion. It's just the idea of having people's lives in your hands and having to treat them, and it just seemed like it was a very stressful occupation to have, and I'm glad I came to that realization when I did. So I instead went on and studied computers, which I enjoyed for a little while, and now I have my day job where I work in education, and then I also write. So the last question is the favorite story that you wrote before being published that has yet to be published. I wrote a lot of stuff before I was published. If you know my story at all, I'll just briefly explain that I never set out to be a writer. I mean, literally, like it was never something that was on my mind. So most of the stuff that I wrote, way back in the day, nothing really kind of like sticks out. But I have written quite a bit of fan fiction, and I've started writing it when I was young, and I've never done anything with it. Most people, when they write their fan fiction, they find some place to like share it online or whatever, because you can't, publish that stuff, because copyright and things like that. But I have one very specific Batman fan fiction that I wrote. I love to this day, so much so that I'm actually adapting that story for a new character that I want to create because I can't write for Batman. And then I also wrote one very specific Betty Boop fan fiction. And now you're like, Betty Boop? Yes. I wrote a story that I thought would just be phenomenal for Betty Boop, But again, I can't write for her. So it's never seen the light of day. It's just, something that I wrote, and I love those stories. I go back and read them sometimes just for fun. So that wraps up my before I was a writer tag. I don't really have anyone to tag. I'm still so very new at this. But if you like it and you want to tag, let me know, and I'll include your link. And yeah, so I hope you enjoyed it, and that's all I have for now. Bye-bye.